生命。
Yes, dear Holy Spirit.
再一次在我们的当中来运行。
Once again, move among us.
主让新的声音在全地被听见。
May the new sound be heard over all the earth.
是呼求的声。
It's a crying out sound.
是呼求的声。
It's a sound of crying out.
是的，主，愿你的荣耀来降。
Yes, Lord, that the weight of your glory fall.
主，我们渴了。
Lord, we're thirsty.
我们在你的面前。
We're in your presence.
我们呼求你的荣耀降临。
We cry out for your glory to fall.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
揭示你的荣耀在我们的当中。
May your glory be among us.
揭示你的荣耀。
Reveal your glory.
主，我们愿意成为可以承纳荣耀的器皿。
We're willing to be vessels to be carriers of your glory.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
我们尊荣你。
We honor you.
我们尊荣你。
We honor you.
启示出你的荣耀。
Reveal your glory.
谢谢主。
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. 感谢赞美主。
Praise the Lord.
今天是 Pastor Philip, 只是因为刚刚
Today's Pastor Philip.
牧师因为今天一样是还是在住棚节。
Because it's still Tabernacles today.
所以让牧师想到耶稣在在节期在住棚节的最后一日他站起来说
When Jesus the last day of the Tabernacles feast, he stood up and said,
他说凡口渴的都可以来喝。
He said, though all who thirst, come and drink.
所以愿意我们在这样的季节。
So may us, during this feast time,
也是能够来喝。
Also come and drink.
然后让腹中的活水一直不断的涌流直涌到永生。
So from within, continuously flow out the living water unto eternal life.
是呼求的时刻。
It's a time to cry out.
是呼求的时刻。
It's a time to cry out.
愿主的荣耀可以降临启示在我们的当中。
So the Lord's glory can fall and reveal among us.
所以今天我们把时间交给 Pastor Philip.
We give the time to Pastor Philip.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
当我们在说愿主你的荣耀降临的时候
，When we say let your weight of the glory falls，
我们要如何的来迎接神的荣耀
？How do we receive God's glory？
我们知道全地都在叹息，等候神众子的显现。
We know the whole earth is sighing for the manifested of the sons of God。
所以当我们在说迎接神荣耀降临的时候
，So when we say receive the glory of the Lord，
全地
the whole earth，
全地都是在等候神众子的显现
，is waiting for the sons of God to manifest。
所以神的众子要先看见，要先领受，要先承接着神的荣耀。
So the sons of God must receive the glory of God。
所以今天牧师要来分享的，就是。我们在我们的里面，神已经预备，在我们的里面有一个宝贝要被显明出来，不仅显明出来，而且能够认出，而且能够承接这神的荣耀。
So today I want to share with you, in us there's a treasure. You must recognize, you must receive this glory of the Lord.
记得在上个礼拜、上上个礼拜，当运凡牧师宣告出来，5781的新年的这个信息的时候，其中有一段他说，在5781新的一年，有一个隐藏的宝、隐藏的珍宝要被显露出来。
So when Pastor Marshall shared the message for 5781, that one of the message she said was there was a hidden treasure that will be revealed.
我们要来看哥林多后书4章第7节。 到底这一个隐藏的珍宝要怎么被显明出来
？Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 7. How does this hidden treasure being revealed?
哥林多后书第四章第七节这样说：我们有这宝贝放在瓦器里，要显明这莫大的能力是出于神，不是出于我们自己。
2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 7. But we have this treasure in the earthen vessel, that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us.
这里说有一个宝贝是被藏在瓦器，放在瓦器的里面。
Now here says there's a treasure that's being placed in a vessel.
这 earthy vessel 其实就是我们。
Now this earthy vessel is us.
我们就是在地上。
为
神所塑造的这一个瓦器
We on this earth is being shaped the vessel.
我们是这一个不仅只是瓦器，我们是一个承接有一个宝贝的瓦器。
We're not just a vessel, but a vessel to receive this treasure.
我们如果回过头来看第四章第六节
，If we turn around and read verse 6,
到底这一个宝贝。所隐藏所带出来的是什么？第六节说，那吩咐光从黑暗里照出来，神已经照在我们心里，叫我们得知神荣耀的光显在耶稣基督的面上。
Verse 6 says, For it is the God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God,In the face of Jesus Christ.
英文说 the light of knowledge of the glory of God. 这是一个光。
Now, English says there's a light, this light.
什么样的光？
Now, what kind of light is this?
是神荣耀的光。
It is the glory of the Lord.
但如果你仔细去读的话，是我们要对这个神荣耀的光有一个知道，有一个认识，才能够将我们这个宝贝真正宝贝所要发出来的，我们就不会怎样，就藏在你的里面。
So then, if you read carefully, you will see that you have to know, you have to recognize this the light of the glory of the Lord of God. So in order to do that, for the treasure to not be hidden but to be revealed from our vessel.
因为这个宝贝的目的是要显出神莫大的能力，因为它带着有它神。有带着神莫大的能力在里面。
Because this treasure is to reveal the excellence of power of God, that this is to show the God, not us.
如果这一个瓦器
this vessel
的目的不是在承接的话，
if the purpose,
如果这个瓦器是在限制，那这瓦器会被打破。
If the purpose of this vessel is not to reveal the treasure, but to restrict, then this vessel will be broken.
如果这个瓦器太小，如果这个瓦器的容纳度不够，这个瓦器会被扩张。
If this vessel is too small, then this vessel will be expanded.
如果这个瓦器不符合形状，不符合形态，不符合而这个所要承接的心意的时候，这个瓦器要被重新的塑造。
If the shape and the characteristic of this vessel is not fitting, then this vessel will be reshaped.
所以当我们在地上说，我们是这地上的这一个容器也好，瓦器也好，我们是 earthy vessel.
If we're saying we are the earthly vessel,
但是 earthly vessel 我们在地上所行走，带着我们的身体，不是我们的目的。
But the earthly vessel.We on this earth is not of our purpose.
因为我们所带着是这个宝贝，而且这个宝贝是有神，是出于神莫大的能力，带着神莫大的能力，带着这个光要在世上显明出来。
But what we carry is this treasure, and this treasure is the excellence power of God, and it is this light of the glory of the God to be revealed.
所以当这个瓦器被打破的时候，我们要欢喜快乐。当这个瓦器已被扩张的时候，我们要有盼望。当这个瓦器被重新塑造的时候，我们知道我们所承接的是超乎我们所求所想的。
So when this treasure is being expanded, then we may be joyful. So when this earthly vessel is being reshaped, then we know that this excellence power of God is being revealed.
好，那到底这个宝贝 藏在瓦器里面这个宝贝到底 是有什么奥秘
But what is the mystery of this treasure?
我们看哥罗西书第一章第二十七节
Let's turn to 1 Corinthians
在哥罗西书
Let's turn to Colossians chapter 1
哥罗西书第一章第二十七节这样说
Colossians chapter 1 verse 27
神愿意叫他们知道知道什么这奥秘在外邦人中有何等丰盛的荣耀就是基督在你们心里成了有荣耀的盼望
Colossians chapter 1 verse 27 To them God willed to make knownWhat are the riches of glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory?
我们很多的信息里面都已经讲到了这里一段很重要的一句话。
Now many messages contain this passage.
Christ in you.
基督在你里面。
Christ in you.
基督在你里面。
也就是 Christ in me.
意思就是基督也在我里面
也就是那一个 manifested sons of God in you and in me
就是神的种子在我的里面也在你的里面
这个神的种子这个实际神种子的生命要在我们里面被显明出来、
so、the,
在我们里面的基督要被显明出来
so the life of the manifested sons of God and the Christ in you is to be revealed
所以在哥罗西书一章二十七节这边
So in Colossians chapter 1 verse 27,
这个奥秘
Now this mystery,
这个奥秘
This mystery,
不是从以色列不是从犹太人的律法里面所显明出来
Does not reveal from Israel, does not reveal from the laws.
这个奥秘
But this mystery,
这里说在外邦人中有何等丰盛的荣耀
It's to be revealed.
要带出这个盼望
Is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles?
当犹太人他们很宝贝他们的律法，他认为说他们在律法当中能够找到基督。
Now the Jewish they treasure their laws; they think they can find Christ in the laws.
但是神有一个更大、更宝贵，就是将他的爱子、独生爱子耶稣基督。放在我们的里面
But God has a much bigger, much more treasured. It is to place the sons of God, His God, only begotten Son, Christ in you.
我们不用在律法、在字句当中去寻找
We're not seeking in the law, in the letters.
因为神已经将基督放在我们里面
Because God has already placed Christ in you.
神将基督放在我们里面
And when God placed Christ in you,
是因着圣灵，我们才能够认出。
It is because it is through the Holy Spirit that we can be recognized.
那什么叫做在我们的里面的基督要显明出来
？And what does that mean that the Christ in us is to be revealed out?
什么说是我们在里面这一个宝贝，隐藏的宝贝要被显明出来
？Now what does that mean? The treasure in this earthly vessel is to be revealed.
刚刚我们读到哥林多后书第六章，第四章第六节第七节，在我们里面有光，光要从黑暗里面照出来。
So in the verse 6 of 2 Corinthians that we just read, it's in us there's a light, and this light outshines the darkness.
所以我们知道光是不可能被隐藏的。
So that we know this light is cannot be hidden.
但是这里又说我们里面有隐藏的宝贝。
But then it also says here that there is the hidden treasure that's hidden inside of us.
但是神的心意不是要我们把这一个宝贝就隐藏起来。
But God's purpose is not for us to hide this treasure.
既然是宝贝，既然是带着神莫大的能力，出于神莫大能力，是一个光，那光就要照。当光照出来的时候，黑暗就不能躲藏。
So if this is a treasure that God is placing inside of us, it cannot be hidden because this treasure is of the excellence of the power of God, and this is light. And when the light shines, the darkness is gone.
想想看，这个光是从神先照在我们的心里。
Now think that this light is God shall shine His light into us first.
好，我们会讲，很多牧师也会讲说，我们就像月亮一样，然后反照出神的光。
And many pastors say we are like moon, that we reflect the light of sun.
但是这里牧师今天要分享的并不是这样子而已。
But I want to share it's not just this.
如果我们只是像月亮一样反照出神的光的话，
If we are like moon, only reflecting the light of the sun.
你想想看，月亮至少到目前人的探索科学，月亮里面是没有自己的生命的。
Now, until today, that our technology that know that the moon does not have its own life.
镜子只能反射光，镜子本身不能发光。
Now, mirror can only reflect, but mirror cannot shine itself.
月亮只能反射出太阳的光，月亮自己不能发光。
The moon can only reflect the light of the sun. The moon cannot shine by itself.
但是在这里所讲，在我们里面隐藏的宝贝并不是这样。而是在我们里面的宝贝带着神莫大的能力，带着耶稣基督的光，是要从我们里面发出来的。
But then here says this treasure that inside of us carries the excellence of the power of God that may be shown through us.
所以我们里面基督要如何显明出来？显明出来的目的是什么？
So how do we reveal this Christ in us? And what is the purpose to reveal?
我们要来看哥林多后书三章六节跟三章五节。
Let's turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6.
哥林多后书三章第三章的第六节。
Chapter 3, verse 6.
他叫我们能承担这新约的职事，不是凭着字句，乃是凭着经义，因为这字句是叫人死，经义是叫人活。经义的意思就是圣灵，所以我们凭着是圣灵，不是凭着字句。
Chapter 3, verse 6.Who also made us sufficient as ministers of the new covenant, not of the letter, but of the spirit. For the letter kills, but spirit gives life.
我们能够承担这新约的职事。
That we are sufficient as ministry of the new covenant.
是凭着我们，是凭着神在我们，给我们里面的圣灵。
It is because the Holy Spirit God has given us.
这个神的灵
Now this God's spirit
基督的灵
The spirit of Christ
基督的生命
The life of Christ
在我们的里面
Inside of us
要被显明出来
Is to be revealed
要被显明出来你不要用一个想象力说就好像把一个珍珠然后从盒子里面拿出来然后展现给人家看说哇我这一颗钻石这一颗珍珠有多漂亮。
Now do not use your imagination in such a way that you have a pearl and then you open the box and show wow this pearl shines and show to everyone.
我们如果仔细读这一段经节
If we read carefully of this verse,
他叫我们能承担这新约的职事。
Who also made us sufficient as ministers of the new covenant.
我大家注意一个字叫承担。
No, take care, look carefully of this word sufficient.
好，刚刚说三章六节，对不对
？No, chapter 3 verse 6.
一样来看三章五节。
Now let's turn to chapter 3 verse 5.
并不是我们凭自己所能承担什么事，我们所能承担的乃是出于神。
And it says here, not that we are sufficient.Of ourselves, to think anything as being from ourselves, but our sufficiency is from God.
我们读到他叫我们承担这新约的职事，我们也读到我们能够凭我们不是凭自己能够承担，乃是出于神的。
Now we have read that He who made us sufficient of the ministry of the new covenant, and we also read that our sufficiency is from God.
如果你能够读 King James 或者是 New King James 的 Bible 的话，有一个字，
you,
这一个字被翻成承担或承担。
If you read King James or New King James Version, there's this word.
这个字叫 fit.
This word is fit.
如果 fit 这一个字被翻成承担或承担，好像我们从中文去了解这个承担或承担是由我们去发出的 我们承担责任，我们去承担这个任务，好像是凭着我们自己的能力，凭着我们自己的聪明才智，要去完成什么样的事。
So in this version, if you see the word fit, if fit from the definition, it seems like we are of some certain qualification, we are of certain abilities to become capable of this assignment.
如果你从这个英文字也好，或者是说你从原来圣经在描述这个字，它叫我们承担这新约的职事，这个承担是有两个意思，一个就是你要有资格，第二个你要有能力，而且是足够的能力，就是 qualify and sufficient in ability.
So if we look at this word of being fit, that has two qualifications. The one qualification is qualified, and the second one is sufficient in ability.
你要有资格，而且要有足够的能力去执行所被托付的。
You must have you must be qualified and have enough or sufficient ability to do.
当我们说有资格的时候，没有一个人，我们知道在世上，当我们说你有资格的时候，没有一个人说我会讲说我有资格，因为当你界定了这个资格，表示有一个标准，表示 有一个人或者是有一个组织来讲说好，你有资格能够做这件事情。
So when we talk about qualifications, no one on this earth will say that I'm qualified. When we talk about qualification, it is there's a certain organization that sets the standard of who is qualified.
在世上的人会用几个字，最明显的一个字叫 certify， 是吗？
Now there are certain words that we use such as certified.
像牧师是CPA， 是 Certified Public Accountant。所以 certify 这一个，你就知道背后怎样有一个程序，有一个资格，它会检视你很多，不仅你的知识，检视你所有哦，可能是甚至在 CPA 里面还会检视你以前有没有犯罪记录，你有没有良好的那个缴税的记录，你有没有这一个那一个，你的以前所学的学分够不够。你的考试是不是通过？当这些听到这个字的时候，表示有很多的标准在检视，这些标准检视才能够被 certify， 你才具有资格能够做这件事情。
So as for me, I'm a CPA, Certified Public Accountant. So if we talk about the word certified, that we know that there's an organization that examines of your qualification. They have certain procedure that you have to go through. For example, background check, criminal records, whether you have paid enough tax, whether you have been on time of your taxes. So when we talk about the word certified, then we know there are certain procedures that you go through.
当神将新约的执事这件事情要交给我们。
But God right here is giving us the ministry of the new covenant.
他叫我们去承担是要做新约的执事这件事情。
So made us fit as ministers of the new covenant.
他说我们够格。
God says that we are qualified.
不仅够格，他也给我们有足够的能力。
Not only qualified, but also given us sufficient abilities.
当说我们能够承担的时候，这样子在这边第三章第六节、第五节、第六节这边讲。其实不是凭着我们，乃是凭着神，借着圣灵，借着在我们里面的基督，神将这样子新约的执事交托了我们。
So when we read chapter 3, verse 5 and verse 6, that we realize that it is not of us being sufficient ourselves, or to think of anything being ourselves, but it is through God, it is through the Holy Spirit.
这个隐藏的宝贝要被显明出来。
Now this hidden treasure is to be revealed.
在我们里面的基督要显出来。
The Christ in us is to be revealed.
这个宝贝的目的要被显出来。
Now the purpose of this treasure is to be shown.
也就是神说我们够资格，神也说我要给你足够的能力。
It is that when God says you are qualified, and I'm also giving you sufficient abilities.
并不是停留在这里说好，那我们就可以去行。
No, we don't just stay here and say, okay, then let's do it.
这是一个过程。
Now, this is a process.
刚刚我说资格和能力。
When I say qualification and ability,
如果在圣经里面 尤其是保罗的书信，保罗的教导。
Now in the Bible, especially Paul's epistle, Paul's teaching,
有很大的部分在讲这两个。
A great majority is talking about these two things.
当你听到资格，当你听到能力的时候
，When you talk about qualification and abilities,
不是出于我们
，It is not from us.
为什么
？Why is that?
因为当我们讲到资格和能力的时候，我们知道儿子的身份跟管家的职责。
So when we talk about qualification and ability, then we see the sonship and the responsibility of the stewardship.
The sonship and the stewardship.
The sonship and stewardship.
儿子的身份还有管家的职责。
Sonship and the stewardship.
当我这样讲儿子的身份跟管家职责的时候，你的灵里突然有一个亮光。哦，原来在四福音书。耶稣的教导在保罗的书信里面有这么多的篇幅，就是一直在强调这两件事情。
So when we talk about sonship and stewardship, then in the four gospels, when Jesus talked about it, then there's so many parts in the epistles are also elaborating about the same thing.
所以当我们能够清楚认识我们有儿子的身份，我们也被赋予管家的责任的时候，我们才能够知道说我们所承担承当这新约的执事，我们才能够清楚认识为什么基督在我们的里面，基督的生命在我们里面，也能够知道为什么我们要有圣灵，有圣灵的大能在我们的里面，要来怎样来承担这一个执事。
So when we clearly know that we have the sonship and the responsibility of a stewardship, that's when we know that Christ is in us and the Holy Spirit is also in us.
儿子的身份，我们来看加拉太书第四章一到二节。
Let's turn to Galatians chapter 4, verse 1 about sonship.
加拉太书第四章一到二节，等一下停留在这边。我说那承受产业的虽然是全业的主人，但为儿童的时候却与奴仆毫无分别，乃在师父和管家的手下，只等他父亲预定的时候来到。
Galatians chapter 4 verse 1 to verse 2. Now I say that the heir, as long as he is a child, does not differ at all from a slave, though he is a master of all, but is under guardians and stewards until the time appointed by the father.
儿子
Son.
儿子的目的是要干嘛？
The purpose of the son is to do what?
承受产业。
Is to receive inheritance.
但是你会把你的产业交给一个婴儿吗？
But would you give your inheritance to a child, to an infant?
你会把你的产业交给一个 kindergartner 吗？一个幼稚园的小孩吗？
Would you give your inheritance to a kindergartner?
你会把一个产业交给一个小学生吗？
Would you give your inheritance to an elementary school?
甚至你会把一个产业交给一个中学生吗？
Even if would you give your inheritance to a middle school?
如果是产业，
if it's inheritance,
就不是零用钱，
and it is not allowance,
是吗？
Right?
产业的意思是什么？
What does that mean, inheritance?
大家想一下，到底什么是产业的意思？
Now let's think about it. What does that mean, inheritance?
产业的意思。
Inheritance meaning?
严格来讲。
Strictly saying.
就是你自己从上一代承接下来，你再传承给下一代的。
It's what you have received from your father's generation, and then you are passing down to the next generation.
我不是讲遗产。
I'm not talking about inheritance.
Estate.
I'm not talking about estate.
仔细听，我不是讲遗产。
Now listen carefully. I'm not talking about estate.
那承受产业的。
But I'm talking about those who inherit.
所以产业是一个 generational.
So inheritance is generational.
所以当我们说我们是承受产业，我们有儿子的身份，神儿子的身份要承受这产业的时候。
So when we say we are heir, we are sons of God to receive this inheritance.
神已经说我们有资格了。
God already said you are qualified.
因着耶稣基督，我们已经得到儿子的名分，是儿子的名分，我们已经具有这个资格。
Through Jesus Christ, we have received the sonship.
但是在这里，我们还在孩童的时候，在师父和管家的手下，只等到他父亲预定的时候来到。
But here, as a child, is still under guardian and stewardship until the time appointed by the father.
这个时候跟奴仆毫无分别。
Now this time, the child and the slave is indifferent.
什么叫做跟奴仆毫无分别？
What does that mean, indifferent?
奴仆的意思就是主人说什么，他就要做什么。
Slave meaning that whatever master says, he do.
主人说，他就做。
The master says, and he does.
主人没有说。
Master didn't say,
他就不要做。
And he cannot do.
主人说向东，他就一定要向东。
Master said go east, he go east.
主人说向西，他就一定要向西。
Master said go west, then he go west.
好，这只是第一个阶段。
But this is the first stage.
是吗？
Right?
比较聪明的奴仆会变成什么？
Now if you're a smart steward or clever steward.
比较精明的奴仆会变成什么？
If you're a clever steward, then you will become what?
变成管家。
Then you'll become
steward.
A steward.
管家就不一样了，是吗？
Steward is different.
管家能够知道，当主人还没说的时候，我就知道他要干什么了。
Now the clever steward will know what to do even before the master says.
何况我们有神儿子的身份。
Now even more that we have the sonship.
何况圣灵在我们的里面能够参透万事。
Even more, the Holy Spirit is in us.
而且是神奥秘的事。
And knows all things, even the mysteries of God.
所以当我们能够分辨，能够参透圣灵在我们里面来能够明白神心意的时候，我们就比奴仆，比管家能够更清楚知道我们父神到底是要什么。
So when the Holy Spirit in us, that we can know the mysteries, then we can be higher than the slaves. We can be higher than the stewards, because we know exactly what the fathers want.
这个就是为什么当我们一直在强调说，有些教会或者有些教导一直在强调我们要当奴仆，我们要有管家的责任。神教都在给我们世上的都是我们照管的，我们要有管家的责任，没有错。但是在这个时候，你一定要很清楚，我们是有儿子的身份，我们是有儿子能够明白父亲心意的这一个灵在我们里面。
Now there are many teachings that we are slaves, that we are stewardship, we have a responsibility of stewardship on this earth, and so on. But at this point here, that we must clearly know we are sons, we are heirs, that we must know.What the Father's heart is.
相反的，很多的教导。
Now, opposite of this.
一直强调我们是儿子的身份。
There are some
teachings. 承接产业的。
There's some teachings keep on emphasizing we are sons. We're heirs.
不管我们像那一个浪子，那一个那将父亲的这个这一个给他的这个财产都败光了，然后回头之后，父亲还爱我们。
So like the prodigal son that has taken away all the inheritance and lost it and come back and the father still accept the son.
所以只要我们是儿子就没有关系。
Now, as long as we're a son, it's all okay.
所以当在这两个不同的强调的时候。
So there's two different types of teaching emphasis.
我相信这不是一个单独可以独立说出来说。我们就是神的儿子，我们都不用管，我们就睡到自然醒，就能够承接产业。
I believe this is not a teaching all by itself that we are sons of God. Then we don't have to care for anything. We can sleep till we wake up.
然后我们不是像奴仆一样，没有自己的思考，没有不用去想说到底我们的主。到底我们的父亲他真正的心意是什么，我们就像机器人一样这样傻傻的做。
Or like the slaves that we don't think, we just follow. We don't think about it, we just do whatever the master says, and we're like machines and keep on doing.
在这边一个很重要，非常重要的一句话，大家很可能包括我以前都读过去就忽略了。
Now here's a very important verse that we may just read and didn't think about it.
就是加拉太书四章一到二节的后半段这边，我们知道承受产业，我们是承受产业的。
It's the second part of Galatians chapter 1, verse 2. We said we are the heirs. We know we are the heirs.
我们知道我们还没成熟的时候要受训练，与奴仆毫无分别。
We know that before we receive the inheritance, we are taking training like slaves.
在师父和管家的手下受训。
Under the guardians and stewardship.
我们都愿意这样做。
And we are willing.
但是有一个事情我们不明白。
One thing that we didn't understand.
直到他父亲预定的时候来到。
Until the appointed time by the father.
好，我要问大家，直到他父亲预定的时候来到是什么时候？
Now I must ask you, what is the time of this appointed time by the father?
好，虽然我是对着镜头。
Even though I'm talking to the camera.
但是我们还是有在座这些弟兄姐妹。
I'm asking the congregation as well.
可以回应。
You can respond.
到底直到他父亲预定的时候是什么时候？
What is the appointed time of the father?
一年？
Is it 1 year?
两年？
2 years?
三年？
3 years?
五年？
5 years?
十年？二十年？
10 years? 20 years?
或者直到耶稣基督再来？
Or until the coming of Christ Jesus? Jesus Christ?
好，有没有回应有答案的？
There any
或者 你想到底想这个讲直到他父亲预定的时候？
Or what do you think?By appointed time by the Father.
好，那我刚要这个是问答题哦，比较难。
It's question and answer. It's a little bit difficult.
那我用选择题。
I'll give you multiple choices.
好，这个父亲预定的时候，第一，好 A,
A
是一段时间，十年、二十年。
It is a period of time, 10 years, 20 years.
B.
是某年某月某时某刻。It's certain date, certain month, certain year, and certain time.
C. 只等到有一件事情要被完成。
Until there are certain things that must be accomplished.
好 ，A、B、C 是哪一个
？A、B、C, three multiple choice.
好。选择 C 很聪明
啊 ，Many of you choose C。
表示我们在这个教导，在这个教会的教导没有白费。
Means that our teachings are still of some worth。
好，那再更难。
No。
什么叫做在一个事情、一个时刻被完成的时候，才叫做父亲预定的时候来到
？Now we got to go further. What does that mean that there are certain things or a certain time that must be fulfilled until the appointed time by the Father?
在我们以前的信息有讲过、
哦。We'll talk about this in the previous passage, messages.
记不记得 dispensation of the fullness of time?
Do you remember 在时刻满足的时候？
好 ，dispensation of the fullness of time.
在时刻满足的时候。
我为什么要英文讲？因为只有这样子才能够完全的表达。
Now, why do I use English to say it? Because only the English words fully fulfill this passage.
一样的，在这边一样的道理，在这边只等到他父亲预定的时候。
Now, the appointed time by the Father is the same.
所以这个时候的满足，并不是只是说一段时刻而已。
Now the dispensation of the fullness of time does not mean just a period of time.
这个时候的满足是指说有一件事情要被完成的时候，这个 dispensation 也就是说这个整个要被展开。
So that means that until this one thing this is accomplished, then this dispensation is being expanded.
好，我这样讲，可能你们明白60%。
Now maybe you can understand 60% of what I just said.
我再做一个解释，你们可能就可以明白90%。
I'll give you another explanation, and you will understand it 90%.
事实上，在这一段话，加拉太书第四章一到二节这一段话是一段法律的解释。
Now, in actuality, Galatians chapter 4 verse 1-2 is actually an explanation of a law.
如果你受过法律的训练，尤其在美国，你受过法律的训练的话，你会读懂。
If you have gone through the training of law, then you will understand.
承受产业虽是全业的主人，在孩童的时候，仍在师父和管家的手下，只等他父亲预定的时候来到。这里是指 a term in a condition. Term 不是 time.
Heir as long as he's a child, not different from all the slaves, although the master is all, but is under guardian and stewardship until the appointed by father. Now this is a term and a time.
That's also when the time has fully right, come. When the time is fully come, 事实上就是 when the term has fully fulfilled.
Says when the time is fully come, another translation, it actually also just means that when the terms is fully completed.Or fulfilled.
我刚刚说这是一个法律 的文字、
oh,
意思就是如果我们知道在一个叫做信托都听过吧
Now this is like a trust
或者是遗嘱
Or like a will
通常在信托或遗嘱里面不会只是写说有一段时间他会写说什么样的条件之下我这一个继承人才能够去动我这个产业
Now, in the trust or will, that it won't say only just a period of time, but it will say only certain conditions that are met, then you can touch this inheritance.
我记得好像有一部电影有演过，但是我详细内容我忘记。但是应该是指说有一位祖父留下来遗产，但是他事先录制了一段影片，要给他知道他有好几个孙子，其中有一个孙子很聪明，可是都很放荡。但是他知道只有他以后经过某样的训练之后经过某样的条件之后他愿意将他的产业能够让这个孙子来承接
So as I recall there's a movie that there's a person that passed away left a great inheritance that he has recorded a video saying only certain qualification is met for this clever son to inherit this inheritance
好那个电影蛮好，我觉得蛮有意思的哈。那个祖父他就是预先先录制好，然后录制好那个影片就放在律师的保险箱里面。那有一天这个祖父过世了，然后律师就把整个家族召聚起来，然后公布这一个影片。
So the movie is very interesting that this grandfather has pre-recorded this video and give it entrusted to the lawyer, and one day that this grandfather has passed away, so the attorney has called the whole family to sit down and watch this video.
然后当然这是一个戏剧，一个电影，所以很戏剧化。哇，大家都很期待说，他们知道这个祖父留下来很巨大的遗产，然后大家都期待，然后大家都在期待那个最大的那一个公司那个产业到底是要给谁？那这可能是。某些人分到了他的汽车分到了他的股票分到他 的那个珠宝然后大家都分只剩下大家期待说哎最后那一个最大的还没有分。
Now, so the movie is actually very dramatic that everybody is expecting. So some of them has inherited their car, some of them inherited the jewelry, some of them inherited stocks. But until the very end, that the biggest inheritance,That everybody is expecting who is to inherit.
那刚刚讲说这个孙子，这个游手好闲的孙子根本不期待什么，他只期待说可能有一些现金留给他，他就已经很高兴了。
Now this grandchild that is just not really doing anything, and he just probably expect a little bit of cash, and that's it.
好，那这一位祖父他录着这个影片的时候，在最后就说。
So at the very end of this video,
我知道你们现在在等什么。
And he says, "I know exactly what you're waiting for right now."
但是接下来我这一段话要跟我的孙子某某人讲。
But following this, these words, these passages, is to speak it to this certain grandchild.
当他开始讲的时候，不是讲说等到你几岁你就可以承接，等到。某年某月某日你就可以承接而是他讲说好等到第一件事你要完成这件事情 再来你要完成第二件事情，你要完成第三件事情。举个例来好了，你要先把你的大学先念完，你要去这个孤儿院去服侍三年，你要去这个地方有两年的经验，你才能够来承接。
So the conditions of this video at the very end to this grandchild is that not of when you reach certain age, or is not when you reach certain date, but is actually when you met certain conditions, when certain conditions are fulfilled. For example, you have to graduate from college, you have to serve. Second condition, maybe serve in the orphanage for a couple years, or so on and so forth.
这个游手好闲的孙子。
Now this.Grandson that didn't accomplish a thing.
一开始觉得很，超祖父所讲，根本就浪费我时间。我现在活得好好的。
He thinks that what the grandfather said is a waste of time.
可是当他再看到说他所要承接的
，But then when he see what he's to inherit,
他只好硬着头皮去做。
He will do his best to meet the conditions.
别人花四年时间念完大学，他可能花五年、花六年。
Maybe some people accomplish.
但他终于把它读完了。
Some people finish college in 4 years, and he finished college in 5 or 6 years. But at least he finished.
好，那过程很有趣。
No, it's
我忘记那个电影的名字，但是如果有机会，大家可以去看。
It's an interesting movie, but I forgot the name.
但是重点是回过头来这里。
Now,
只等到父亲预定的时候来到。
Until the time appointed by the father.
就像我刚刚描述的。
It's like what I just described.
这一位要承接产业的孙子。
Now, this grandchild is to inherit this inheritance.
所等他的不是时间。
What is await of him is not time.
等他的是一个阶段，一个阶段。一个阶段所要被训练所要被塑造之后他才能够去承接这个产业。
What await of him is this stage and second stage and third stage is the training and the shaping and until the end that he can inherit.
所以当我们看见在这里儿子是承受产业的。
So we see here son is to receive inheritance.
我们是儿子，我们是神的儿子。我们是要承接产业的。
We are the sons of God. We are to receive inheritance.
所以，当我们在训练，当我们在塑造，我们被打破，我们被扩张的时候，你要记得是为了要承接产业。
So when we are being shaped, when we are being training, when we are reshaped, when we are broken, when we are reshaping, then you must remember that we are to do all these for receiving the inheritance.
一定要记得爱我们的主，爱我们的神，不是像那严苛的主人，然后吃饱没事干就虐待奴仆。
Now you must remember the Father, the God that loves us, is not like a mean master that have nothing to do but to abuse us.
可是当我们忘记了我们是儿子的身份的时候。
But when we are forgotten, when we have forgotten that we are the sons of God,
我们忘记在我们里面有这个宝贝的时候。
But when we've forgotten there's this treasure within us,
我们不知道这个宝贝就是基督在我们里面要被显明出来的目的的时候。
That we did not know that is Christ in us to be revealed.
我们的心态就会像奴仆一样，被虐待的奴仆。
Then our heart would
所有遇到的事情都觉得不合理。
Then our heart would be like slaves, that like us abused slaves. Everything that happened to us is like abuse.
以前我们在当兵的时候叫做合理的叫训练，不合理的叫磨练。
When we're in the military, when it's reasonable, it's called training. When it's unreasonable, it's called shaping.
所以不管我们被训练或者是被磨练。
So no matter if you're being trained or being shaped,
我们都有一个目的。
We have one purpose.
我们要承受产业。
We are to receive inheritance.
所以你有这样子才能够在神的面前有这样的信心。
So because of all this, then we can be in before Lord to have faith.
好，我知道你会翻 faith.
Or trust.
也不是 trust.
Or confidence. Confidence.
为什么？为什么我不是说等他翻译错，而是很多人念这一段经节，真的像就是照字面上不了解他原来要讲的，也就是哥林多后书第三章第三节到第四节。
So when we translate this, a lot of times when we read these verses, we think just the letters. But then when we go to the 2 Corinthians chapter 3, you will know.
哥林多后书第三章的第三节到第四节这样讲，你们明显是基督的信，借着我们修成的，不是用墨写出来，乃是用永生神的灵写的，不是写在石板上，乃是写在心板上，我们因基督，所以在神面前才有这样的信心。
2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 3 to verse 4. Clearly you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh, that is of your heart. And we have such trust through Christ toward our God.
第四节我再读一遍，因基督，我们因基督，所以在神面前才有这样的信心。用 New King James 或者 King James。
So, in New King James Version, says, and we have such trust through Christ toward God.
好，那 New King James 是讲 trust， 事实上这个 trust 能够翻译的更完整一点。We have such is the reliance and confidence that we have through Christ toward which reference to God. 我们因着基督，所以在神面前才有这样的信心，才有这样的 reliance and confidence.
So to elaborate clearly of what this trust or this verse is saying is that we have such reliance and confidence through Christ toward God.
在神的面前有这样子的 confidence， 有这样子的信心。
Now, toward God through Christ, we have such confidence.
在希伯来书说着，我们因着耶稣基督宝血得以坦然无惧来到父神的施恩宝座前。
Now, Hebrews says that through the blood of Jesus Christ, that we can come freely to the mercy throne of Father.
我们在神的面前是坦然无惧，而有这样子的信心，这样子的 confidence。
Now we can come freely, so we have such confidence.
唯有耶稣基督的生命，唯有这个宝贝，在我们里面宝贝被显明出来的时候，我们看见了。我们不仅灵里看见，而且我们显明出来，回应了我信息一开始讲，不是一个反射，而是我们里面真的发出像神一样的光的时候，我们在神的面前才有这样子的信心。
Now, only when the Christ in us is being revealed, like the beginning of the message, it's not a reflection, but Christ in us, the light has shone through, then we will have such confidence.
在这里，哥林多后书第三章，保罗是写给哥林多的教会。
Now, 2 Corinthians chapter 3, Paul is written to the church of Corinth.
所以在这里
Now, here,
他用这个荐，就是推荐信这一个做形容。
Now he used a description of such the word epistles or letters of recommendation, epistles of recommendation.
所以推荐信在我们现在是很清楚知道什么叫推荐信。
Now in today's that we use a lot of letters of recommendations.
当有人帮你写推荐信的时候。人家不是相信你这一个人，是相信帮你写的那一个人。
Now, when someone is writing a letter of recommendation for you, it is not that when the person that reads it, they don't believe in you, but they believe in the person that written the letter.
所以保罗在这边说。
So Paul here says,
我们，他在当神的使徒，在传讲，这一个新约的执，成为新约的执事的这件事。的推荐信到底是谁？
Now, so Paul here talk about that we, as being the minister of the new covenant, who is writing these letters of recommendation?
他说不是别人。
It is of no one else.
就是你们。
But clearly,
就是神的教会。
You, It is the church of God.
就神的百姓。
It is the people of God.
当世人看见神的百姓，我们里面那基督的生命被隐藏的宝贝被显明出来的时候。
When the people see the Christ in you has been revealed.
神看，世人看见了。
The people saw.
这个就是我们的推荐信。
Now that is our epistle of commendation.
不是用墨水写出来的。
It is not written by ink.
那是永生神的灵所写的。
But by the spirit of the living God.
不是写在石板上。乃是写在心板上面。
Not on the tablets of stone, but the tablets of flesh that is your heart.
所以我们在神的面前有这样子的 confidence.
That's why, therefore, we can before God have such confidence.
都是因着耶稣基督。
It's all because Jesus Christ.
都是因着在你跟我里面的基督这个宝藏这个宝贝被显明出来。
It's all because the Christ that's in you, that's in me, being revealed.
所以在这新年，尤其是在这个大日，在这个
，So in this new year, in this Feast of Tabernacles,
神将这样子的启示启示出来。
God has given us this revelation.
通过他的仆人启示出来。
Through His servant.
那隐藏的玛纳要被显明。
The hidden manna is to be revealed.
那渔民要被显明
，The remnants are to be revealed.
隐藏的珍宝要被显露
，The hidden treasure is to be revealed.
神的心意要透过他的百姓，使世人看见。
God's heart plan through His people to be revealed before all people.
我不需要再强调我们现在世上所面临的这些混乱了。
I don't need to emphasize the chaos that we're facing today.
每一件事情对我们来讲，以前都是不可思议的事情。
Now everything to us in the past is very different.
It's beyond our imagination.
It's beyond our imagination.
Everything happened is new to us every day.
Yeah, everything happened is new.
但是因着我们里面这个宝贝
，But because of this hidden treasure inside of us,
我们因基督，所以在神的面前。有这样子的信心
，because of Christ that we can be before God have such confidence.
感谢主也祝福每一位弟兄姐妹。
Praise the Lord, bless all of the brothers and sisters.
希望这不是一篇信息而已。
May this not just be one message.
就像我刚刚所讲的
，like what I just said.
神到底在我的面前，在你的里面设定了什么样的时候，叫做时候满足
？Now, like what I said, what did God put as a condition in you or in me is called the fullness of time.
我们这一个瓦器是要被打破，是要被扩张，是要被重新塑造。
Now our vessel, this earthly vessel, is to be broken, is to be broken, is to be expanded, is to be reshaped.
为的是要使这个宝贝被显明出来，使基督的生命、基督的馨香被释放出来。
For the purpose of this hidden treasure to be revealed, for the Christ.The life of Christ to be given.
感谢赞美主。
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
好，我们要来回应。
We will respond.
来，运凡牧师要来回应。
Pastor Marshall will respond.
Hallelujah.
也开导是回应，也是一种回应。
It's also a response.
因为Pastor Philip 没有讲到后半段哈。
Pastor Philip didn't talk about the second part.
因为他只有讲到做神的就是神的儿子。
He talked about being sons of God.
然后要等到父亲指定的时间，然后领承受产业。
Until the appointed time to receive the inheritance.
就是。父亲指定的时刻
Until the appointed time by the Father.
圣经上面其实我刚刚在听的时候
When I was listening, 圣经
提到不是时间其实是直到
It's not time, it's until.
所以在使徒行传的三章二十一节
So in Acts 3:21,
天地都留着耶稣。
Heaven and earth is,
but heaven, 天留着耶稣。
The heaven is withholding Jesus back.
只等到
until
万物复兴的时刻。
The time of the fullness,
until the rest, 就是 restoration
of all things.
Okay.所以这里有一个事情需要被完成，而使得耶稣可以再来。
So here something has to be accomplished before Jesus can come back again.
然后在希伯来书的九章十六节
，In Hebrews 9:16，
这里讲到遗命，就是 will。
Here it talks about a will.
你可以翻去看一下，就是如果一个人活着
，If someone lives，
他写的这个 will 是不能够被被成就出来，直到他死的时候。
This will cannot be accomplished until they die.
所以
，so
刚刚在讲的
，what we were talking about，
讲的不是时间
，it's not about time。
当然也是时间
，of course it is time。
因为从小孩子到长大成熟，所以是一个过程。
So from a child you mature and grow up, it is a process.
可是重点不是时间。
But the main point is not about the time.
而是在于这个器皿本身的长大成熟。
But this vessel maturing and growing up.
所以
，So
我为什么要站上来回应
？Why do I have to stand here respond?
因为我记得我有说到，我看见有戒指。
I remember I said there was I saw a ring.
还有外衣。
And a mantle.
戒指代表着我们做神儿子的身份。
The ring represents us as sons of God.
所以光只有知道神儿子的身份，没有知道所要承担的责任，那会成为妈宝。
So if you're just sons of God, but you don't know how to take responsibility, that is
妈宝就是 mommy's boy, 就是
mommy's spoiled boy.、
那如果你只知道做奴仆。只有工作。
If you only know how to be a slave, only know how to work.
那你会变成了法利赛人或者工作狂。
Then you become like a Pharisee or just a worker.
就像耶稣说，离开我去吧，我不认识你。
Jesus will say, "Depart from me, I do not know you."
为什么
？Why?
因为没有真正的关系。
There's no true relationship.
所以我们必须要在这样子的关系的里面去建立起来。
So we have to build in this relationship.
然后牧师讲到外衣
，also talk about the mantle。
外衣代表着
the mantle represents
在这个生命的里面，不是只是承接的产业
，this life not just receiving the inheritance，
而是神所指派给你的领域
，but the realm God sent you to
territory，
the territory God sent you to。
我记得我上次有说过
，I said this before，
在清朝
，in the Qing Dynasty。
所有的皇家的孩子都称为女的，不，男的称为阿哥。
All the Huang children, the boys became princes.
什么大阿哥、二阿哥、什么阿哥 ？OK， 好。
Sort of prince.
雍正是四阿哥。OK，
there's one that was the fourth prince.
OK， 然后女的就叫做格格。OK，
all the girls are princesses.
好，可是
but。
就只有你有被差派出去，你有你的属地的。
Only those that are sent out, you have your territory.
你称为什么
？What do you become?
亲王，王爷
，like the king.
因为代表着你必须或者称为 lord
or landlord.
我觉得，所以你才会有这样子的权柄去执行这样的权利。
So you have this authority to decree.
所以
，so.
一个基督徒
，a Christian，
不能够只是妈宝有戒指。
You can't just be a mama's boy and just have a ring.
你必须因为神一定有指派给你的任务跟使命。
God has destined for you a mandate, a destiny.
所以你的一生都在寻找你所被放置的那一个领域。
So your whole life you're looking for that place, that position that you've been put in, that territory.
所以你的一生。都在寻找，也都在被揭示出来。
Your whole life is unveiling. You're looking, searching.
所以，当你找到了
，So when you find it，
找到了属于神所托付你的领域的时候
，You find the realm, the territory God gave you.
你能够站在那里行使这样子的什么这种神所赋予你的 权柄
You can stand there and use the authority God gave you
1581年开始
Starting from 5781
神的孩子要显现除了你知道你是永生神的儿子
God's children besides for knowing that you are sons of God
你必须要有这样子的权柄可以行使出来
You have to have this authority to come out
所以你一定是长大成熟站在神所给你托付的领域的里面
So you're grown up and mature and you stand the territory God gave you
所以5781年
So 5781
是长大成熟是是长大成熟的一个展现的时刻。
It's a revelation, revealing of the growing up and maturing.
还有牧师要说，之前牧师有讲过，圣经真的很重要。
The Bible is very important.
四福音书
，The four Gospels.
耶稣是展示道成肉身神的儿子。
Jesus revealed the Word became the Word became flesh, the Son of God.
他展现出来神儿子。的这一个根基跟他所要展现出来执行的权柄
The Son of God, the foundation, this authority, he revealed all of it.
然后耶稣就回天上去了
And Jesus went back to heaven.
然后使徒行传就是哇展现出来了
And Acts reveals all of it.
可是我们就会说可是那可能只有使徒可以做得到了
And we'll say, oh, maybe only the apostles can do that.
感谢赞美主圣经没有在那里就停了
Praise the Lord, the Bible didn't stop there.
所以你会发现使徒的书信
So you find the epistles
保罗三分之保罗写新约的三分之二
Paul wrote two-thirds of the New Testament
都在教导我们我们的根基立在哪里
It's all teaching us where do we put our foundation
我们站立的根基都是因为耶稣基督
We stand on the foundation of Jesus Christ
是因为神的爱子的缘故
It's because of the God's love Son of God
然后
and then,
他教导 我们如何去
and he teaches us how to
去被建立起来
how to be built up
神的心意是什么
what is God's will
然后只等到我们透过这些来建立我们然后可以彰显神的种子
And through this, to build us up and to reveal the sons of God
所以保罗所有的书信都在教导一件事情
So all Paul's epistles are teaching one thing
怎么可以在地上却能够彰显在天上的实际
How to be on earth but reveal the reality of heaven
所以整本的圣经新约的圣经
So the whole New Testament
是在教导神的儿子们的身份
It's teaching us the status of the sons of God
然后怎么样子去兴起
And how to rise
所以牧师说过
So I said it before
5781年开始
5781, the beginning of it
不是在坐在那里的时刻
It's not time to sit there
而是兴起的时刻
But time to rise up
可是这个兴起不是因为你跟我的兴起
But not rise up, it's not about
是你跟我兴起可是不是你跟我
It's rising, it's you and I rising, but it's not about you and I
因为不再是你跟我的意思是基督在我们的里面是这个宝贝显出这莫大的能力
It means it's Jesus Christ, the excellence of the power of him in us
所以不用去看哎呀我是金器、Gold
Don't
gold
just
vessel,
say that I'm a gold vessel
或者是银的
Or I'm a silver vessel
或者说奇怪了我怎么连那个金器银器连木器都不如是瓦器
Or maybe I'm not even a wooden vessel
不管你是什么样子的 earthly 地上的器皿
or whatever earthly vessel you are
我们是因为有这个宝贝去显明
we have this treasure to be revealed inside of us
所以现在是兴起的机会
it's time to rise
是兴起的机会
it's an opportunity to arise
我们已经知道我们是永生神的孩子
we already know we're sons of God
所以我们不用坐在那里哎，我没有办法我没有办法
So we're going to sit there and say Oh, I can't do this, I can't do this
你已经有这样子的身份你也可以有这样的权柄可以在你的地牧师要说我不敢说你能够在你什么什么什么领域的里面
You already have the status as authority I don't know which realm territory you're in
至少你这块地啊
At least you yourself, this earth
这块属于张运凡的我这块地
This Marsha Chan, this earth right here
我可以带下这样的权柄
I can bring down this authority
Amen 所以我们要从现在开始。
So starting from right now.
其实牧师还蛮喜欢看一些连续剧。
I like to watch some drama.
看连续剧，我不是在看连续剧。
I'm not just watching the drama.
其实我是在看这些演员，有的演员你会发现他怎么这么，似乎就把那个演员就像就是他。
That these actors, they become the whole persona.
你知道吗？你跟我就是要如此行。
You and I should do the same way.
因为基督在我的里面呢、啊、
，Because Christ is in me，
所以我是要去彰显出耶稣基督。
So I'm revealing Christ Jesus。
所以我要变成了那个我既然是主角
，So I'm the main actor。
我就要把这个主角，哎呀，不知道怎么讲，我跟这个主角就是合一的。
So I and the actor were the same, were the same role。
我要演出来，让人家觉得说。Hey, 他就是基督。
I'll play out the role, then they'll say this person is Jesus Christ.
就是这个道成的肉身的耶稣基督在我的身上显现出来。
This is the word become flesh, Jesus Christ revealed in me.
有的那个一看，哦，老天哪，那个演的那个主角实在是只是长得好看而已。
Some people, oh, the actors just they're pretty, but they're not very good at acting.
那都我对我来说看了以后就说，哎，打叉。
And then I give them an X.
OK， 然后我会看到，哎呀，这个怎么能够演那么好
？And look at this actor. Oh, they're so good.
然后我就会去看，哎呀，他们原来是什么上海戏剧学院呐、啊，什么什么中央戏剧学院呐、啊，什么北京戏剧学院。
Oh, they went to Beijing or Shanghai, the major acting schools.
然后我上次跟Samuel 在讨论。
And I was discussing with Samuel last time.
到底是上海的好呢，北京的好呢，还是中央的好
？Is Shanghai, Beijing, or 中央 ？Which acting school is the best one?
目前我看来上海的还是比较厉害一点。
I think Shanghai has the best acting school.
题外话。
That's side track.
重点是在于。
The main point is,
我们要真正的去知道这样的主角。
We have to truly know this main role.
你才有办法真正的去活出这样子的主角。
You can truly live out this role.
因为你跟我就是一出戏啊。
Because you and I were drama.
所以我喜欢去看，有的真的，我要说那个主角演的就是那个剧本，似乎就是为他写的。
Some of the actors, so their role, they is as if it was written for them.
他一生似乎就是演出这样的一个经典就好了。
Their whole life is just to act that main piece out.
所以你跟我也是这样被期待的。
So you and I, same expectation.
我们已经知道我们是谁。
We already know who we are.
牧师要说，不要再一天到晚都要在叫牧师去强调说，哎呀，你是神的儿子，神好爱你哦。
You don't need every day to pass out, oh, you're sons of God, oh, God loves you so much.
我们已经过了那个阶段了。
We're all about that process.
我在想想，如果 Samuel 现在24岁
，If Samuel right now 24 years old,
我一天到晚都说，哎呀，妈咪好爱你哦 ，I love you very much.
And every day, I have to say, oh, mommy loves you very much.
我想我的儿子可能会说，妈，我可能立刻就说 ，Thank you, mommy.就挂了。
My son would probably say, "Thank you, mommy," and just hang up on me.
因为他要长大成熟。
Because he needs to grow up and mature.
因为他就是这个推荐信。
Because he is this letter, this recommendation letter.
对呀，所以我们一定要去看见这个长大成熟。
So we have to see the growing up and maturing.
所以是时候我们要带着权柄，然后出去执行的时候。
It is time for us to bring authority to decree.
刚刚我们讲的
，What we spoke of，
Pastor Philip 刚刚讲的
，Pastor Philip he just spoke。
我们承担着新约的执事
，We're sufficient of the new covenant，
New Testament， right？ OK， 所以新约的执事
，We're
承担这一个新约的执事
，We're sufficient ministers of the new covenant。
意思是我们要去执行出。
So it means we have to act out.
神所托付我们的，在我们的生命的当中。
What God gave us in our life.
所以不要只活在。我知道神爱我。
So don't just live in, oh, I know God loves me.
我已经就是神的儿子，这个是不会改变的。
I'm already sons of God. This won't change.
所以现在是我要站起来，能够带出去执行出这个权柄的时刻。
This is the time for me to bring authority to decree.
Amen.所以这是我的回应。
This is my response.
我们能够有一些时间，回应，然后也祷告。我觉得很奇怪。
I think it's very interesting.
每次说回应的时候，大家就很安静了。
Every time I see respond, it's very quiet.
就不会去祷告。
Nobody prays.
不会祷告。
No one knows how to pray.
可是当我们在那边用 Zoom 说，哦，今天为 A 祷告，为 B 祷告，为 C 祷告，每一个人就会开始开口祷告。
But then when we're using Zoom and we have prayer lists, A pray for B, C, everyone prays.
牧师要说，我们要从这个也跳出来。
We have to come out of this too.
我们不是只是会为这些 list 的祷告而已。
We're not just praying for a list.
而是能够在这样子的里面去听见 Pastor Philip 没有说的东西。
But in this, to hear what Pastor Philip didn't even say.
然后能够去回应，因为祷告敬拜都是你在对着神啊。
It's to respond because prayer, worship, and prayer is all worship is relationship with God.
好，所以我们花一点时间来回应，也祷告。
We'll spend some time to respond and pray.
Amen.